our worldview today, more fallout from the nationwide protests in Cuba. At least 100 protesters, along with activists and independent journalists, have now been arrested for their reported involvement in Cuba's largest demonstrations in nearly 30 years. Among those detained, the leader of Cuba's largest opposition group and a journalist for a Spanish newspaper. Demonstrations erupted over the weekend as thousands took to the streets to protest a shortage of food and medicine. Activists streamed the rallies on social media, chanting for freedom and demanding President Miguel Díaz-Canel step down. The president has blamed U.S. sanctions for Cuba's economic decline. Over in South Africa, more than 45 people have been killed and nearly 800 people arrested in demonstrations connected to the jailing of former leader Jacob Zuma. Police clashed with crowds for yet another day as some protesters looted stores and burned shopping malls in areas around Johannesburg and in Zuma's home province. Demonstrations began last week after Zuma was sentenced to 15 months in prison for failing to cooperate with a corruption investigation into his administration. But the protests have expanded beyond that, with anger over inequality in the country and economic decline tied to COVID-19 restrictions. And here's one way to boost the declining birth rate. Iran's Islamic propaganda arm is launching a dating app sanctioned by the state. The app Hamda, which means companion in Farsi, reportedly uses artificial intelligence to match bachelors with a spouse. Users need to undergo a psychology test before browsing. And then once a match is made, the app introduces the families with service consultants present, offers to accompany the couple for 4 years after marriage. This comes as Iran's supreme leader warns about declining birth rates and couples getting married later in life. Iran's parliament passed a bill earlier this year offering financial incentives for marriages and for couples to have kids.